What's going on? Welcome back to the channel, One Man's Walk. I am your host, Gamal, back at you with another one. So what do we have for you today? Kendrick Lamar dropped a new single, what seems like a shocking single, but we got The Hard Part 5. I don't know if this means we're getting a new album. Hopefully it means we're getting a new album. But while we have this, why not discuss? Let's deep dive into what it is. And we'll do that right after this intro.
Clean your house music. You can clean too.
Welcome back. So like I said, Kendrick Lamar dropped a new single, The Hard Part 5. I assume that means we're getting a new album. Not quite sure, but hopefully that means we're getting some new heat before the year's out. Maybe around the summertime, maybe we'll get something. And we will get into this song, but of course, let's get this housekeeping out the way. If you guys have not already done so, please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on your post bell notification so that way you don't miss any of this amazing content. As you can see behind me, one of the latest videos is up. That is the Mobb Deep, the Infamous. I did review that album recently. I also reviewed just a couple minutes ago the Mozzie new single, Tell the Truth. Not sure if this one will go up first or the Mozzie, but both of those videos, that video will be up, as well as some other things that are up on the channel. We got some sneaker reviews up, the Jade 5 Horizon, the Jade Horizon Air Jordan 5s. Couple Yeezys is on the channel. The BBCC Mary Versus is up. So it's a ton of things on the channel. I think you guys will enjoy it. As long as with this Mobb Deep, I also did a breakout for Give Up the Goods specifically to kind of deep dive a little bit more into that. And I might do another one for Trife Life. So just be on the lookout for all these amazing things. Now, Kendrick Lamar, I have been on, I want to say right before the Good Kid, Mad City came out when he was on everyone's projects, and I was really excited. Kendrick is that guy. Kendrick can rap, right? And so we know Kendrick Lamar kind of treats himself like Maxwell or Jaheim or D'Angelo, whatever you want to say. What I mean by that is individuals who have such a built-in fan base, they don't feel the need. You know, like Drake comes out every year or every other year. I don't know if Drake needs to do that, but his brand is to continually do that. Whereas Kendrick Lamar brand is more so, I'ma just be secluded. You're not gonna know anything that's going on with me. And then boom, I'ma just hit you with something. You're gonna get new music. And when I give it to you, you're gonna eat it up. And so that's what we have. So let's check it out. Let's see what we got. I want to hear, I want to say it's that Marvin Gaye. As I get a little older. So off the break, this is that, I think it's Joe Button, I Want You Back. I want to say the intro to Mood Music 1 is what this is. Now it was flipped slightly differently, but it's the same record. Realize life in perspective. Let's bring it up a little bit. Take the charge, homies. Don't your baby mama once you hit the yard. That's culture. 23-hour lockdown. That somebody called, said your little nephew was shot down. The coaches involved. I done seen do 17. Hit the halfway house. Get out and get his thrown out. Looking to buy some car washes. So he says a lot real fast. He says, analyze, risk your life, take the charge. Homie, sex your baby mom once you hit the yard. That's culture. 23-hour lockdown that somebody called, said your little nephew was shot down. The culture is involved. And so I like that as he starts off, one of the things he keeps referencing is the culture. And the culture to me feels cold for Negroes acting up, right? You say the N-word or whatever, you guys not on curse on the channel. But like when Negroes is acting up and not doing what they're supposed to do, or we blame it, almost like what the Boondocks would do, where they kind of take us behind a wall and Huey would be like, look, man, this is really what's going on with black people. You got Negroes out here, Negroettes out here acting a fool at times. And he's replacing that Kendrick with the word culture, which is really slick of what he's doing. I said I do this for my culture to let y'all know what it look like in a bulletproof rover. So that is the flip on that. I think it's that Jay. I do this for my culture to let you know what it look like in a Testarossa. I think that's the line, the Jay-Z line. I want to say that's what that is. The streets got me fucked up. Y'all can miss me. I want to represent for us. New revolution was up and moving. I'm in Argentina wiping my tears, full of confusion. Water in between us. Another peer's been executed. History repeats again. Make a mess in front of us. What the same skin to do it? So it's a lot said in there. That's the culture. Point the finger, promote your remote location, witness protection, then they gonna hold you. The streets got me messed up. Y'all can miss me. I want to represent us. New revolution was up and moving. I'm in Argentina wiping my tears, full of confusion. Water between us. Another pair's been executed. History repeats again. Make amends to find a dude with the same skin to do it. But that's the culture. And again, it sounds like he's saying, look, I felt like we were on a different trajectory. Black Lives Matter. I feel like that's what he's saying. Now, if I'm wrong, you guys let me know. It feels like he was going in saying, hey, Black Lives Matter. This is where we are with this. It looks like we're finally on the same page as black people. Let's stop going around killing one another. There's a bigger fight to be fought as we're trying to not hopefully exterminate ourselves while other races potentially are trying to exterminate us as well. And he says he's in Argentina, tears falling down his eyes. When he realizes, like, another pair has been executed, history repeats again, make amends to find a dude with the same skin to do it, but that's the culture. Meaning that no matter how hard you try, in some instances, it feels like some things still kind of remain the same, which is sad, which is why, hence, the tears are coming down his eyes, right? But then he gets into this crazy, real nice breakdown of a story, talking about himself is it from a martyr standpoint, as if he's been killed. And so that right there, it gets pretty nuts. Hold on, let's get up to it. Celebrate new life when they come back around. The purpose is in the lessons we learning now. Sacrifice personal gain over everything just to see the next generation better than ours. I wasn't perfect. The skin I was in, I truly suffered. Temptation and patience, everything that the body nurtures. I felt the good, I felt the bad, and I felt the worry. But all in all, my productivity has stayed urgent. Face your fears always. So he says, celebrate new life when it comes back around. The purpose is in the lessons we learning now. I really like that, because sometimes it's not always the end result. I am an end result person, but it's not always going to be the end result. Sometimes it is really about the journey to get to the end result, the lessons you learn along the way in which you grow in the midst of the ups, the downs, the highs, the lows, the happiness, the frustrations, the joy, the tears, like all of it comes together. And that's part of the purpose he's talking about. Like, it's the lesson learned that we find. The purpose is in the lessons we're learning now. He says, sacrifice personal gain over everything just to see the next generation better than ours. And so he's saying, look, there comes a time where you have to actually think beyond just you, beyond just what you want, what you need, and look and think about how does what you're doing now affect those who are to come. The people who are, all of us are actually living or enjoying the fruit of somebody who came before us in whatever capacity. And he's like, look, we need to set something up for the generation to come. In order to do that, we have to make personal sacrifices now, so that way they can have a better situation when their time comes, which is really admirable, really dope. Pay dues, made rules change out of love. The same views made schools change curriculums. It didn't change me staring down the barrel of that gun. Should I feel resentful? I didn't see my full potential. Should I feel regret about the good that I was into? Everything is everything. This ain't coincidental. I woke up that morning with more heart to give you as I. All right, he's saying a lot. Now, this is where we really going to get into it. Reflecting on my life and what I've done, paid dues, made rules, changed out of love. Them same few made schools change curriculums. Them same few made schools change curriculums, but didn't change me staring down the barrel of the gun. Should I feel resentful? I didn't see my full potential. Should I feel regret about the good that I was into? Everything is everything. This ain't coincidental. I woke up that morning with more heart to give you. So I like that. He says, reflecting on my life and what I've done, paid dues. He's actually talking now. When he changes to that, he's actually saying, like, at that moment, like, I'm staring at the barrel of the gun and I'm at reflecting on my life. I'm reflecting on what I did. He was like, look, what have I done? Pay dues, right? I made rules, changed out of love. Meaning the way in which the art that he brought and what he brought to the table in love helped change somebody else's mind. It helped change somebody else's trajectory. It helped change somebody else's direction. And he's like, them same few made schools change curriculum. The people that I affected then turn around and started making change in a community because I'm affecting the people who have influence in the community, individuals who can change the laws or change the schools, change the curriculum in the schools, things of that nature. And he said, but then he realizes, but that didn't change me from staring down the barrel of the gun. Almost like I thought about that, and I thought about Nip and how for all the good Nipsey was trying to do in the community, it still didn't stop one individual who, for whatever reason, wanted to see him dead. Right now, whether they went premeditated to see him dead or whether it just so happened, emotions ran high. But whenever, however it happened, a trigger was pulled in wanting to see him dead. And Kendrick is like, it doesn't matter how much good I do. It doesn't matter all the things that I've done. If somebody wants me dead, they want me dead. They don't care about the lives I'm changing. They don't care about what I'm bringing to the table. Because they don't like me, which is sad, right? But that is the reality of people. We kind of discussed that on the Dave East on the John Lennon record. See, so he's like, should I feel regret about the good that I was into? Everything is everything. This ain't coincidental. Meaning, like, he said, I woke up that morning with more heart to give you. He didn't wake up that morning thinking this is going to be my last day on earth. I woke up wanting to do the thing that I had been doing, which is trying to infect you with love to help change your life and give you a different perspective, a different outlook. Love it, right? So let's just pick it up.
As I bleed through the speakers, feel my presence. To my brother, to my kids, I'm in heaven. To my mother, to my sis, I'm in heaven. To my father, to my wife, I am serious, this is heaven. To my friends, make sure you count them blessings. To my fans, make sure you make them investments. And to the killer that spared at my demise, I forgive you, just know your soul's in question. I seen the pain in your pupil when that trigger has squeezed. And though you did me gruesome, I was surely relieved. I completed my mission, wasn't ready to leave, but fulfilled my days, my creator was pleased.
Okay, this is nuts, I'm sorry. And then he says, you know, he's talking to different people, to my mother, to my father, to my wife. I'm in heaven. To my kids, I'm in heaven. And then he says, to my friends, make sure you count in them blessings. Meaning, don't take life for granted. All of us could be gone at any given moment. Yes, you think I'm going to live this long life. You think I'm going to be here, but I could not. So cherish me while I'm here and cherish your life. Cherish your loved ones. Count this as blessings. He says to my fans, make sure you make them investments, meaning all the stuff I was trying to do in a community, all the stuff I was trying to show you and give you different, I need you to know and let it not be in vain. Don't let it be in vain what it is that I was trying to do, right? And then he says, then he speaks to his killer. And this is actually something I can't even lie. This is what makes it so crazy a song. I've said this to myself multiple times. Maybe I've had a few conversations with just a few small people about this. And I'm like, man, If I ended up dying where someone shot me, I would hope that even in my death, if it meant that somebody else might get saved, give their life to Christ, somebody else might bring forgiveness or love together, then it was still worth it, right? Like, it doesn't mean that I'm like, oh man, I'm excited to die early or nothing like that. But looking beyond me and being able to say, even the individual, if it were to be like that, where somebody were to shoot me, I hope that individual would get saved. I hope that individual would, that would be maybe the last straw and they say, you know what, I gotta change my life. And so while it would suck that I wasn't here, if they can have a different life or different outlook based on that, it was still worth it. You know what I mean? Like, that's why I really loved this verse. It was so airy in hearing it. He says, and to the killer that sped up my demise, right? Because he's realizing, I feel like I'm dying before my time. He said, to the killer that sped up my demise, I forgive you. Just know your soul's in question. I see the pain in your, I seen the pain in your pupil when that trigger was squeezed. And though you did me gruesome, I was surely relieved. Meaning like, look, man, I understand that maybe you didn't even know what you were doing or wanting to do in that moment. Maybe, yeah, your emotions were running high. Pride or whatever got in the way, but even you were having second thoughts. And he was like, I'm going to let you know I forgive you. So in case you feel haunted about taking away Kendrick Lamar, right? I want to let you know I forgive you. And then he said, I completed my mission, wasn't ready to leave, but fulfilled my days. My creator was pleased. Meaning I may not have done everything I thought I was going to do and wanted to do, but I did everything God needed me to do and planned for me to do, because I'm gone. And if I wasn't, if it was more for me to do, I would still be here. But the fact that I'm gone lets me know I got done what I needed to get done. This is a nuts verse, a nuts song. I really enjoyed it. There's way more lyrics to it, but I wanted to leave with that because I wanted to leave with that because I just thought it was nuts. But this is a great song. It gets me really hype and geeked in anticipation for this new album, for whenever that drops. And whenever it drops, you know we're doing it on the channel. It'll be my first time doing a Kendrick Lamar album on the channel, so I can't wait to deep dive into that. As always, you guys, I hope you have a wonderful, blessed, productive, stress-free day, weekday, weekend, whenever you're listening, however you're listening. I thank you for listening. Till next time. I do want to say, so this is new, but this is the outro. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. I thank you guys for sticking out to the end of the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Stick around for some of the other content that you see up right now. As always, I hope you guys have a wonderful, blessed, productive, stress-free day. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. Turn on your post bell notifications so that way you don't miss any of this amazing content. Share, share, share